What's up? And here we go again. So I'm playing around with this bass design, seeing what we can squeeze out of it, seeing what it can do. It is quite interesting, I will admit that. I'm intrigued by its capabilities. So it is strange, isn't it? I added these little spiky things here. I'm going to see if they help at all. Our hoping is that they will sort of like guide the heroes around it. So we're going to see what works, what doesn't. So we're going to play around a bit more. I'm going to try this with Q, with four heroes. It's ridiculous. I know I shouldn't do it, but can you do Q with four heroes? Oh God, this is going to be painful. Put your bets below. Can we do Q with four heroes with this setup? Oh God, this is going to be painful. Oh God, this is going to hurt. This is going to hurt really bad. Oh, stop screwing around. Oh, Thunderstrike on this side too. Oh, hopefully the Thunderstrike lands over here. Please, over here. Please, over here. Where does it hit? Oh, it did hit over there. Thank God. The gods have appeased us. Oh, can we get a launch here? Can we get a launch? Can we get a nuke? Can we get a nuke? Where's the nuke? Where's our nukes? Someone's got to have a nuke. Don't let Pumpkin Duke die. Oy, that is dangerous. These are dangerous times we live in, I tell you. All right, so the flyers aren't really our concern, I think. I think our concern is that Thunder God. That Thunder God and that Atlanta Corps are ridiculously overpowered. Those guys have it made. So they're the bosses of this. Can we get a stun in here? We need a stun really bad. Thank God. That Atlanta Corps is ridiculously overpowered. It goes off, we die. It goes off and we die. So that's how that goes. What do you guys see? What do you guys see? Dun, 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 dun. Q2. Can we mod it? Q2 is fine. Q3. Can we do a Q3 with this setup? Oh. Oh, yeah. This is ridiculous. Let's try. Okay, now Atlanta Corps is going to be targeting a hero. So this is the bad spot. This is where the danger comes in. Danger, Will Robinson, danger. Okay. Q3. Now we lost lots of our buildings here. Lots and lots of our buildings. We are down for the count. Okay, this is the side that's really dangerous right now because that thing wants to proc. I'm hoping they're not going for anything useful. Proc. Really need some damage here. That damage output has to be high. That damage output has to be super high. There it goes. Q5. Oh, dear God. If we get this, I'm going to laugh. Oh, it's a bottom spawn. That should give us additional time. But these guys over here do hurt. Do not count this wave out. This wave can still do some ridiculous amounts of damage. Don't count it out. This little guy can be annoying. Where is the boss going? We're tricking the boss up here. That Atlanta Corps is our bad spot. That Atlanta Corps is what is our worst nightmare right now. We need to kill that Atlanta Corps. Thank God. All right. So now we don't. I think he's going after Santa, which is a good thing. That gives us plenty of time to attack. This is what this base does. It gives us plenty of time to attack the boss. Lots of time to attack the boss. Lots of time. But now this boss does have a good chunk of HP. So we're going to four-man queue. Oh, lulz. I wonder if I can farm four-man queue. Oh, don't even get me started. I might actually do that. Don't tempt me to do something stupid like four-man in queue with no garrisons. Don't tempt me to do it because I will do it. Don't even get me started on it. I probably will do it. Oh, God dang it. What are you guys getting me to do here? This is bad for my health. four-man queue. Is it a fluke? Can we do it again? We shouldn't do that. That's wrong. Four-man in queue. Oh, it's dangerous, man. That's like playing with razor blades on your wrist. It's not a good idea. Oh, what are we doing? Am I going to do it? I should not do this. No, don't. Why are you clicking these buttons? Stop clicking buttons. They're bad for you. These buttons are bad. They're bad, I tell you. Don't do it. Don't. It's bad. Warning. Warning. It's bad. This is bad for your health. Don't four-man queue. Four-manning queue is redonkulous. Don't try it at home, kids. Don't try it at home. Four-manning queue. That is just... Can we do it again? Don't try it at home, kids. Don't try it at home. This is dangerous. These are dangerous waters we live in. Ooh, that is a really double bad backspawn. They're all on the backside. All on the backside. Ooh, that is really bad. That is really, 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 really bad. Really, 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 really bad. Raw, really. Raw, raw. We survived a double back on Q. That is what this base is good for. It can survive things that you really shouldn't. That is something you should not be able to survive. A double back spawn is bad. Ooh, I hope we don't do too much damage here. Thank God, because too much damage is actually a bad thing to do. Too much damage, you could actually time out. So let's not do too much damage. Okay, so those little guys should be able to take that out. We're a little bit low on our bases, but oh my God, we're alive still. This is ridiculous on Q. If I can four-man farm Q, I'm going to laugh my ass. I'm going to LMAO it. You know what I mean? I'm going to just... Four-manning queue. Can you four-man queue? I don't know. Should you be able to four-man queue? I don't know. What am I doing with this base? This base is dangerous for me. I'm tempting things I should not be tempting. I'm almost wanting to try to three-man queue. Don't make me do that, guys. You guys saw me three-man wave P. Don't make me three-man wave Q now. Don't even start that discussion. Back away. Back away. We're not doing that. That's bad for you. Oh, that's going to be horrible. You guys are bad. Bad for me. Bad. Oh, what's this? Q3 again? Where are we getting the spawn here? That is... Actually, I think they're all going to go for the inner base, which isn't that bad at all. And watch this Santa proc. Boom! Rocked him. Santa's just wrong. He's not letting him breathe. Watch what Santa does here again. He's going to proc again. Oh, boom. Boom. Santa, oh, that's nasty. Don't do that on their face. Okay, this group, I don't think has Thunder God. This group has Thunder God. This is the dangerous group, but the dangerous group has actually been weakened. They're going for this spot right here. Cupid can take it out, though, so that would be a little bit annoying. Hopefully we get some procs here and kill it before they take that down. Oh, they did take out our Pumpkin Duke. Don't! That was slightly bad. No Pumpkin Duke means we really need a bottom spawn for boss. No bottom spawn for boss, we dead. We's a dead. Or really, really close to dead. Whatever the equivalent is. Oh my God. But doing this well, four heroes on wave Q with level 159 in the group, we shouldn't be doing this. This is not what you're supposed to do. This is evil. This is not good for your health. Do not try this at home, kids. Do not try this at home. Bottom spawn. Okay, it is a bottom spawn, so that gives us some leeway, but not much. Not much at all. That still puts us in a lot of danger. A lot of danger, Will Robinson. A lot of danger, Will Robinson. Can we get a nuke? Boom! Slows the boss down. There we go. Now, if you get too close to the wall, the boss will go and attack through. We gotta get this proc. We gotta get this proc. Get the proc, baby. Get the proc. Kill the boss. Oh, don't Lanacore. Lanacore is about to go off. That was going to be really, really, really bad. Really, 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 really bad. Oh, this is like ridiculously bad here. This boss has so much HP. Look at the ridiculous amount of HP on this boss. Oh, I gotta work on getting my slow up on Santa. No, don't get so close to the thing, Santa. Santa, no. Santa, no, Santa, no. Now, the good thing here, though, is Druid and Vlad Dracula both have revive. I don't know if either of them use their revive yet. We're gonna find out. That one did not. This one, I don't think he reused his revive either. So he's got to run back and forth, so that does give us a little bit of time. Not much, though. Not much. Not much at all. Oh, if we, I guarantee if we had the Pumpkin Duke still, that would have been a victory. Oh, yeah. Kaprok, come on. I don't know if we have any bombs left. Dear God, do we have bombs? I don't think we do. If we do, that's ridiculously overpowered. But no, we don't have any bombs. We are going to lose this. We shouldn't win this. We shouldn't be attempting this. This is encouraging us not to do this. So let's learn our lesson and don't do this anymore. Oh, don't have another bomb. Don't have another bomb, because that's going to just give us bad ideas. Don't have another. Oh, it has another bomb. Oh my God, we almost won it. It's encouraging us to do bad behaviors. It's encouraging us to do naughty things. Don't. That means I'm extremely close to formatting wave queue farming. Don't make me do this. Don't. It's bad for you. It's bad for you. Oh, this is ridiculous. This is ridiculous. Let's try it again just for lulz. Just to prove that we shouldn't do it. Hopefully it's a loss. We need it to be a loss so it doesn't make me try stupid things. Pray for a loss, everyone. Pray for a loss. Because a loss means I won't do this ever again. Please lose. Please lose. Let's discourage me from doing bad things. We don't want to encourage this. We don't want to encourage this. It's bad behavior. Bad behavior, I say. All right. What do you guys think? Is this insanity? Doing four-man queue with heroes? My heroes, like I said, they need some stuff for their special abilities. Most of them are just 7-9, so that's just sad. The only one that's 9-9 is this bad boy right here. My Pumpkin Duke is 9-9. That is the best hero I have right here. That bad boy. So, once again, four-man queue. Can we do it? Oh, dear God. Oh, we were so close on that last one. That was extremely ridiculously close. That was just uncalled for, nerve-wrecking close. That was bad of them to do that to me. Okay, we got a backspawn here. Those backspawns are horrible, horrible, because they are going to take out that, and they're going after Pumpkin Duke. Thank God we're going to lose this. Whew. See? Now we're never going to attempt this again. This is bad. Bad for us. Let's never, ever do this again. If they still make me win this, I'm going to get cranky. Yeah, we should. I can probably farm Q. What this is telling me is that Q is farmable with five heroes for me. And I could just do it with nothing in the towers at this point. So you can see that this is the Icebreaker less is more version 2 kind of thing going on here. For those wondering the base design, I trimmed the corners, did some weird stuff. Playing around with it a bit, basically. Oh, there's a Thunder God in there. This is going to hurt. This is going to hurt right here. We're going to die right now. Watch this sucker kill us. We didn't die. Huh. I was expecting the Lanacore to proc and murder us. But I was wrong. So that's a thing. And we're going to be revited up for that. Well, not revited up anymore. I was hoping Santa to be revited up, but that's not going to happen anymore. Ooh, this spawn should definitely kill us. This one, we should not live here. This is our death. This is our doom. This is our doom. Oh, that Thunder God strike was really powerful. Oh, that, we should not make it any further. Oh, Lanacore proc'd. There we go. This is going to kill us. It has to kill us. There we go. Now we're dead. Thank God. Whew. Did not want to attempt formatting anymore. It's possible to four-man wave queue, and you could potentially actually farm four-man wave queue if you have higher level stuff. Don't try it with a level 160 or below hero in the group. Really don't. Or maybe do. If you're crazy, go for it. Go for it. But what do you guys think? Insanity? Ugh. Four-man wave queue. Why not, right? Why not? Oh, but as soon as I get Santa to 99 and I get Vlad to 99 and get this guy to 99, heck yeah. Q could be four-manable. You could four-man Q with ease. But I don't have 9 of 9 yet on those guys. I only have 9 of 9 on this. 7 of 9 here. 7 of 9 here. 8 of 9 here. And those 9 of 9s really, really do matter. They really do. They really, really do. But what do you guys think? What do you guys think? It looks pretty interesting. Well, I will get going. I will not try another. We lost two. Yay. That's going to make sure that I don't attempt this for a while. I need to get shards so I can get to 9 of 9. I need to stop doing weird things. Thank God I lost. Whew. Gonna make me start doing stupid things. All right, have a good one. What do you guys think of the setup there? It's pretty interesting. If you're gonna be using this, you got to use Santa in front. You have to have a Santa and you have to have a Druid. These are pretty much requirements due to the setup here, due to these hallways and how things go. If for the majority of time Santa or Druid would be picked, and Santa or Druid will never, so far I've done this a lot of times, I've never seen them hop the wall. That's great. The problem with flyers is they can get up close and get aggro. He hasn't done it on this account yet, but I've been trying on my other account and it did happen one time. But that means that a flyer could get aggro through the wall versus these guys that just go up to the wall, they don't get aggro that way. So that's good. Good for us. Good for us. Oh, craziness. Insanity. Insanity indeed. Now, what I'm thinking what we could actually do is, if we can really play around with the internals of this, to the point where they don't hop the wall and we do the junk in your trunk setup and you push all this forward. If we could get away with doing that by using these extender pieces, could then make it so the circle isn't anywhere close for them to get to the wall to pull aggro to make whatever the heck it is going to attack through. And that could potentially give us the ability to really abuse this new setup. We could really, really abuse it. So I might just like make a little 2-bit piece out like this to purposely make them go to here to go in, which really, really does well for us. So if that works, that'd be great. I'm going to test it out. I'm going to do some more testing and playing around. So with making that little extension here, we could move all the stuff forward and then gives more space in the back for bombs or whatever the heck we're looking for, or put additional buildings back there or whatever the heck we're looking for. It could be interesting. We could abuse this a bit more. I think there's more to be had, more naughtiness we could do. Ooh, I am tempted to do naughty things with this space. The space is tempting me to do crazy things. But you guys see it. You guys see what it can do. All right. You guys have good ones. Have a good ones. And what do you guys think of this new version here? What do you guys think of four-manning wave Q? what do you guys think of three-manning wave Q? Now, that second one pretty much showed that three-manning wave queue, because, like, what, Pumpkin Duke died the first wave? I think he died the first wave.
That means he really wasn't there. So that means we could have potentially three-manned it there. I've got naughty thoughts. No! Get him up ahead. I'm not going to try and three-man queue. What do you take me for, an insane person? No, we're not going to do that. I need my shards. I really need my shards. Once I get to 9 of 9 on all my heroes, I'll goof around a lot more. I'll goof around a ton more. I got to get to 9 of 9. Let me get to 9 of 9. Once I get to 9 of 9, then we can do that. All right. Have a good one, guys. Have a good one.